Good evening, everyone. A massive manhunt is underway for a second man believed to be involved in the Oklahoma City bombing.
April 22nd, 1995. That was the first time our very own Howard Thompson appeared on Channel 11.
Yeah, what would be the first of thousands of reports over the course of 23 years on the air here in the world's most competitive TV market. Well, tonight, we are saying so long to a legend.
Yeah, he has been cursed at, he has been chased, yes. He's been attacked just recently. All in the name of getting justice, though, for PIX 11 viewers out there. Howard surprised all of us today, announcing his retirement from television news, signing off after a lifetime in front of the bright lights.
Yeah, truly the end of an era. Let's look back at the amazing career of Help Me Howard.
So how do we protect people from becoming the next victim of a dog attack?
That's from my first Help Me Howard 23 years and 163 days ago. But what is that thing on my head? It's been a great run. It's led me to some classic stories and situations.
You better calm down.
I am calm down.
That's not a calm face.
Like that story at a New Jersey safe company.
All right, no bats.
And this one you may remember just this year. Knucklehead Jose LeBron Pimentel came out swinging. He was charged with assault. You never know when that kind of thing can happen. Fortunately, it's been pretty rare, given all the scammers, schemers, and scoundrels I've faced.
You are harassing us! You are harassing us!
Squatters may be the most detestable, like the Baileys. He's an ex-cop, and she, well, this is what she is.
We've been harassed for the last 4 months.
You're getting locked up.
They eventually got evicted after months of not paying rent.
I'm not going to answer their question.
And we caught the former Bergen County prosecutor auctioning off bogus sports memorabilia he'd seized from a criminal. Eventually, the prosecutor made refunds.
I'm so excited.
In 2016, with the aid of a couple of big Beyonce fans, we pulled a little sting on a guy selling bogus concert tickets.
Excuse me, how you doing? Howard Thompson, PIX 11. Where you going, genius? Are you kidding me?
The people you meet as Help Me Howard. In 2014, I was just trying to get an elevator repaired at a Howard Beach building when I met two lovely women who ran things at the complex.
What's your name?
None of your business.
What? Hi, Officer Howard Thompson, PIX 11.
Get out of my face.
Robert.
What's up, sir?
How you doing? Long time.
After a Staten Island stakeout, I finally met a guy I'd been chasing for several years, Robert Schneff. Even his own mother says he's shady.
He's quite a con artist.
Schneff took a bunch of people by tearing apart their homes and never doing construction work they paid him for. I've seen far too many crooked and unlicensed contractors pull that stunt.
We need a police car here right now.
And forget about unscrupulous car dealers, too many to remember.
When, Jared? When are you going to take care of this?
It's business as usual, I guess, isn't it?
I could have done monthly stories on this guy at his Plaza 57 jewelry store. He specializes in getting hold of your items and then hoping you'll forget about them.
Good to see you again, Lee.
It's always interesting. The wedding band.
What a character. And this fellow got ripped off for a bad Batman suit he purchased on eBay. I barely got a glimpse of one guy hiding from me back in the day.
Warren, what kind of man are you, man, sending 15-year-old girls out to the streets of the city to sell some illegal perfume, and they end up in jail? Get off that couch, man.
Hold on. There's that hair again.
I just have to say one thing really quickly.
Certainly.
I like you bald, but that was the best toupee I've ever seen.
Yes. Wasn't that Danish was something else?
The anxiety
that thing used to cause.
Now, where were we? Oh, yes. Remember my old Feel Good Friday segment?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I used to give away $1,100 on the streets every day.
For real?
For real?
For real.
Are you serious?
I'm totally serious.
Then there were the matters of life and death.
I woke up with that new kidney and I thought, wow, it actually happened.
Our stories helped get at least three people life-saving kidney transplants.
Do we have a smile? All right, I hear that.
In 2014, we met 7-year-old Maya Rose, who had a mystery illness leaving her unable to speak or walk. That turned out to be a genetic mutation. Our viewers really responded and helped get answers for her single dad, Alex.
We're not done with this by any means. All right, we're here to fight for you.
In 2012, we helped get a drug company to provide an experimental life-saving drug to a young Manhattan woman.
All my pain is gone and I have so much more energy. Howard, you have been incredible.
These are some of the stories I've done and people I've met during the past 23 years and 163 days. New York, thank you very much. I'm glad to have been able to help with all of your problems, small and large.
You're my mitzvah, man.
All right, Alfredo. Okay, yeah.
Sure.
I like that. It's an Italian thing.
That's Italian.
Italian. It's a good thing. We like that. Well, yeah, go get something to eat?
Yes.
All right, come on.
I want you all to understand that help me, Howard is your man. He followed my story right to the end. Thank you, Howard, for being my friend.
That was fantastic. You are entirely welcome. That is the first. Well, little Cena, I'm speechless.
Oh, my God. Has it really been 23 years?
Oh,
it has been. New York, thank you so much. It has been an honor and a pleasure to do this kind of work in the city. Just really wonderful. I mean, who gets to pay to be a comic strip character for 23 years? You know?
Well, it's just great.
I got to tell you something. We're honored to have you, as is New York.
Thank you, thank you.
You made a couple of enemies along the way, but you've helped so many more people.
You think?
And I got to tell you, we were all watching those in just the years that we've been here, looking back going, oh, I remember that person you helped and that person.
Yeah, right.
You have just done so much. I mean, there's just, it's incredible,
it has
really.
It has been a blast and an honor. I'm speechless. It's been quite a day around here just talking to everybody and saying goodbye to the people. PIX11 here at 220 East 42nd Street has been my home away from home for 23 years.
It's always
this,
your home.
This guy over here, the conversations we used to have.
But I gotta mention something here, okay, to the audience. What you witnessed in Howard for over two decades, right, is spontaneity.
Mm-hmm.
This guy has a gift. These are stories. But when he turns around, a guy's running away and says, genius, that's not scripted.
No.
That's a gift.
It's called being a smart.
I really got to tell you, from a veteran to a veteran,
thanks,
that's a gift. And I think I really appreciate it. The anchors appreciate it. And the audience appreciates
it. It's been wonderful. You guys have been great. You've been like family to me. Onward and upward. New challenges ahead, Corey.
And personally, I'll just say this. An inspiration. A guy I was watching long before ever being in this business. And, I mean, I feel honored to have, you know, shared the stage with you.
You're too kind. You're too kind. Reciprocal, really. You're all wonderful. Just great. Great co-workers. I couldn't ask for a better staff of people to work for the past 23 years. It has been a blast. New York, I love you. See you around the way, as they say.
You have changed a lot of lives.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right.
We'll be right back.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question, but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life.